Hey, everybody. We are back here at PRI 2022 on the stage here in Indianapolis, and we are joined by a top alcohol dragster driver and a top fuel driver. You may have heard of them. You may know them. Tony Stewart, Leah Pruett. How's everybody doing this morning? You were part of the opening festivities of the PRI show this morning.
Yeah, that's not something I'm used to doing, is getting up early and being somewhere. I was actually at the top of the escalators ready to go in the building at 6:30, and I'm like, what has happened to me? What have I turned into?
Did you have to drag him out of bed?
No. I mean, that's not the normal Tony time, but if Tony has to show up somewhere and it's important, like the breakfast, I mean, it's huge. For those that haven't been, it is like, I mean, it's almost thousands of people. Yeah. It's at least 1,000 for sure. So, I miss the breakfast on purpose. I get to wake up with Tony and get morning Tony all the time. So I let everybody else get morning Tony.
So, you know, we look back over this 2022 season, you know, we get to the end of the year, we're in this wintertime period. How would you kind of sum up your year as not only a driver, but also as somebody who has kind of gelled together with this new team of yours?
Well, I think one of our crew members said it best, we've had the best year yet.
That's a great way to put it.
Nowhere but up for us. I do want to say something that we're very proud of is that every single member of TSR Nitro returned.
That's huge.
And in Nitro racing, the turnover rate's huge all the time, and there's always that silly season, and we didn't have to deal with any of that.
Yeah.
We addressed everything pretty much during the countdown and ways to improve, and now this is, I guess what I love so much about this off season right now is that we get to work on our improving our performance instead of just establishing us
right.
as a team.
The thrash of making stuff is over. Now you get to lock in.
Yes, and so it feels kind of like your normal PRI and the normal dig that you have and what we love. So I'm very pleased overall.
Yeah.
And we, you know, our performance at the end of the season really picked up, and we learned a lot of things. We probably intend to test more than anybody else out there before the season starts with the amount of time we have off. And I'm invigorated.
That's great.
And that's what I love the most.
Speaking of that invigoration, are we going to see you more than once maybe this year in a dragster? Are we going to see a little bit more of that? What's going on?
We'll do a formal announcement, but we're definitely going to be back.
Good.
Running some races this year.
No, it's
junior,
great.
Junior dragster.
I don't think you could get my fat ass in a junior
Listen,
dragster.
Listen, they make the stuff called Crisco. We could get you. We could totally load you in there with
it. It's not getting in that I'm really concerned about. It's the part where I'm like, I have to get out, and I can't get out. That's the part that worries me the most, I think, at this point.
From your perspective, you look over this year, the same question I asked Leah, but from your own eyes, from your own perspective, as you watch these teams kind of come together, you watch Matt Hagan win a bunch of races, be involved in a championship chase. Did it meet your expectations when you go to sleep on December 31st? So you're going to say, okay, this was a successful year for TSR.
I do believe it is. I mean, the thing that people don't realize is it was two polar opposite teams.
Yeah.
Matt's team was turnkey. I mean, bumper to bumper, and everything. People they switched two people in the off season. Going into this year, where Leah's side, I mean, Neil Straussbaugh was the only person we knew and the only person we had when we started everything.
Yeah.
And literally, we had less than a handful of people at this time last year. And, for Neil and Mike Domagala to assemble the team, the right people, probably the most impressive thing from my standpoint with Leah's team this year was, A, her patience, because she was more than capable of doing her job.
Yep.
We just weren't able to give her the car that she needed. But what I was super impressed with out of the gate was a group of guys that work on that car that had never worked with each other, and how seamless it was out of the gate. For me, something that was important was when that car goes down through, no matter what the lap time was, it's not spraying liquid out.
Right.
We're not throwing parts
out. It's assembled
out.
Correctly. The job's being done.
It's not a yard sale. Right. We're not making everybody wait on us. And how sanitary those guys made that car. And that made me feel good from the owner's standpoint of going, these guys are on top of it. Then it's just a matter of getting that performance that we're looking for. So I know it was a stressful year for Neil moving from a co-crew chief role to that crew chief role. And it doesn't sound like it's a big step, but as you know, and Leah knows, in this
Huge.
Industry, it is a big leap. in that step. So I think getting him some confidence this winter, and like Leah mentioned, I'm excited for the team to be able to go test. I remember when Leah was driving for Don, I mean, it was hard to get Don to let him to go test, and I'm like trying to kick him out the door and trying to get the trailers, like, go somewhere, run.
Go do something.
We need to make laps. So I'm all behind it. I'm excited to go with him this winter and watch him test. I know she really loves to test and thrives on that. So I think it's good for all of us.
Yep.
But I'm excited. I mean, I think Matt's team did a great job all year. There was one little period in the year where they struggled a little bit, but they came on strong at the end of the year. It just was a little bit too late, unfortunately. But we were in the hunt. We were in the mix at the end and, you know, won races, and Leah's team won a race. So I call it a win. I feel like it was a successful first year.
You know, you mentioned over the course of the year a bunch of times culture and the culture of this team, and the fact that everybody's coming back, as rare as that is another kind of testament to that, what that culture is. And what is that? What is the, if you had to pick a word or a way to define the culture of what your team is at TSR, what is it?
I would say the single word of appreciation.
Yeah.
Just collectively, all the way around, and showing that to each individual and their spouses, and acknowledging the time that they put in, the effort that they put in, and appreciating each one of that. It's not just when you win a race and like, thanks, good job, guys, and we finally, you know, we got this trophy.
Yeah.
It's the little wins all the way that get there, and when they feel appreciated. Well, I know how I feel when I feel appreciated, and it's it's actually bigger than a Wally.
Yeah.
And so that's the culture that Tony has created by his management team, and we call Mom Kelly, Sister Ashley. everyone enjoys what they do because they know that, because they're appreciated, and
I think something that was really cool too was, you know, like we said, we were still assembling people at this part of the season last year, but we kind of had a feel of what we were building when the wives and the girlfriends were bringing dinner to the shop at 5, 6, 7 o'clock.
That's old school.
Because
huge.
It was 7:38 in the morning till sometimes midnight, 1 o'clock, and the guys were still there. And for the spouses to let their significant other be at the shop that long, and then on top of that, take turns taking care of all of us at the shop and feeding us, I think it really set the tone.
Yeah.
And I said it when we had our Christmas party this last Saturday that, you know, they're the unsung heroes. I mean, they don't get to go to the racetrack much, but their support, we feel that at the shop.
Yeah.
We feel that when we're on the road, because the environment that they set at home when they come to the track and when they come to the shop, I mean, it carries over. So having not only great people that are working on the cars, but the support system from the spouses, it really, I think, got everything off on the right foot for us.
And look, I saw the photos on social media of the Christmas party you had at your home, and it was beautiful, and everybody was there, and that's the type of thing you look at and you say, this is how it should be done, right? It's not like you don't just send them a card and say, hey, Merry Christmas. It's like, no, you're inviting these people in your home. That kind of family aspect, again, we go back to the culture word, but that's kind of where it all starts and ends. So. No, it's great. It's been a fun adventure. It's been great to work together a couple times in the booth. We had a lot of fun. We always talk about on TV, there's the show that you see, and then there is the real show that happens off the air. And the real show is really, really good, except
way
we would
better.
All lose our jobs immediately if it ever got aired.
But the real show is on a Dodge Mopar Motorsports on Instagram. That's where the behind the scenes of 2023 is going to be, so tune into that.
That's going to be great. Leah, Tony, congratulations on the year this year. Congratulations on the success in Vegas and the win in Denver. And look forward to seeing what 2023 has in store. And I'm sure you guys are not busy at all for the rest of the show.
No, we really don't have anything to do. Like, we just have everything to do. So, no, it's great. It's as soon as the season's over, everybody kind of, we all get kind of depressed. But the good thing is we always have PRI to look forward to, because you get to see your friends. You get to see all the new products and what everybody's done, you know, all these companies, what they do to make our cars faster. And, you know, from the owner's side, I get to go try to squeeze every dime of free stuff I can get out of all these manufacturers on parts and pieces that we need. So it's definitely a busy time. And, you know, for me, then having a sprint car series and the other teams that we have, we've got our awards tomorrow night for the All-Stars. So it is definitely a very packed 2-3 days for us here.
They'll be hustling. We'll be right back with more from the PRI stage here in 2022.
Thanks, Brian.
Thanks, guys.